In this video, I'm gonna show you how to use the surface tracker inside DaVinci Resolve, which is great for textures and warped surfaces, such as t-shirts, skin, or fur. Let's get right into it. So I've already got my timeline open and the B-roll waiting, and today we're gonna stick a DaVinci Resolve logo onto this lion's face. Why? Simply because we can. So first of all, I have to tell you that, unfortunately, the surface tracker is only available in the studio version of Resolve, so if you've got the free version, you're not gonna be able to use it. But stick around and let's have some fun. Okay, so unlike the other trackers in Resolve, the surface tracker works in the color tab. So let's head over to color. So here in color, make sure you have your effects tab open. Now, all I have to do is type in surf, and the surface tracker will appear. Now, just drag it somewhere inside the node tree, like this. And as you can see, it's got two green arrows and two blue arrows. So first, we're gonna connect the output of our clip into this first green input of the surface tracker, and the output of the node right here on this green input. And now we can see the menu. So we're gonna start here in bounce. Here's where we're gonna create our tracking points. So let's find a moment in the video where the lion's face is completely visible. Like, here's perfect. Now, let's draw our points. Great, now we'll go to the mesh tab. And here you can see all the tracking points got linked together. So here we have a few options. We have the point number limit, where we can increase or decrease the number of tracking points, and the minimum point spacing, where we can increase or decrease, well, the spacing between the points. And keep in mind that adding more points and lowering the minimum point spacing is gonna get you a more accurate track, but it's also gonna slow down resolve. So it's up to you. I'm gonna increase the point number a little bit. Now we can go to the track tab. All you have to do is click on this button right here, track forward then reverse, and let Resolve do its thing. And don't worry, it might take a while. Okay, let's take a look at the tracking. Looks like we've got it. So now we're gonna open our media pool and add the logo to the node space. We can close the media pool, open up the effects, and now we're gonna connect this green output right here into this green input right here. And as you can see, our logo appeared, but now we've got to adjust it. So let's click on our surface tracker, and here on result, we're gonna come to positioning and change it from interactive canvas to sliders. Now we have the option to manipulate our attributes. So let's scale down, move it up a little bit. Okay, but as you can see, we have a black stripe behind our logo. And how do we get rid of that? It's very simple. We just have to connect this first blue output right here into this bottom blue arrow right here. Like this, and it's gone. Now let's adjust it a little more, like here is fine, and let's see how it looks. Yeah, well, it's definitely stuck in our lion's face. But to make it more realistic, let's change the last attribute. We're gonna come down the options, and here in composite type, we're gonna change it from normal to overlay. That way, it will blend a lot better to the lion's fur. You can play with the opacity as well, this is fine. And now, let's see how it looks. And that's how you use the surface tracker inside DaVinci Resolve. And if you like this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you want to learn about the camera tracker, just click on this video showing on your screen right now, and I'll see you there.